Hi, in this video we will see how to connect DroneEngage to a Opel board which runs Ardupilot using local Ethernet. We are going to use Raspberry Pi 02 wireless to run DroneEngage. This board is very small and it is the same size as Raspberry Pi 0, however it is 5 times powerful than Raspberry Pi 0. That's why we can connect a camera and stream video from it. In the same time, we will use Opel board, and Opel board, as we know, it is a sensor board connected to a Raspberry Pi board, which can be Raspberry Pi 0 or 4 or whatever board. We will use Raspberry Pi 0 to minimize the power consumption, as we don't need a higher computation power to run Ardupilot. So we are going to connect these two boards using USB, and we will activate the Ethernet on the USB so that these two boards can see each other as if they are connected to a local LAN. The connection is very straightforward. We are using an OTG connection with a USB cable. This board, which runs DroneEngage, connects to this device, and through this device it connects to the cloud where I can receive the data from Android or DroneEngage web client. On the other side, I want to be able also to receive a direct connection from this port to Mission Planner or QGround Control on my mobile using Wi-Fi. That's why I use this device here, and Raspberry Pi Zero is connected to it by a Wi-Fi, and it broadcasts a local telemetry data to this mobile. This is a Raspberry Pi Zero 2 connected to a camera, and it is connected via USB to Raspberry Pi Zero that is connected to the Opel board sensor. So this board is Opel board, the Opel sensors, and the Raspberry Pi Zero 1 that control the sensors and run Ardupilot. This is Opel, this is a Raspberry Pi Zero 2, and it runs DroneEngage. It runs the software that reads or and reads the data from the Ardupilot board, which is the Opel board here, and it has the DroneEngage communicator that communicate with internet, and it has DroneEngage camera that reads from this camera and can stream video to DroneEngage web client. I choose to connect the board using USB and activate Ethernet over USB. So I just need to power this board using that board. The USB is connected via OTG to this USB connector, and it connects here. And these boards can communicate via an Ethernet between them. So this is fast and reliable. And I connect to internet via a wireless modem. This is the wireless modem I use. Because what I want to do is that I want this board to be able to connect to this Wi-Fi wirelessly, and this Wi-Fi, by the way, I will attach it here under the drone. So this Wi-Fi, this board will connect to this Wi-Fi wirelessly, and this Wi-Fi contains a 4G chip that will connect to internet. On the other side, I want this board to connect to this Wi-Fi wirelessly as well, and it will stream data to this Wi-Fi to my mobile, because I want to run Mission Planner or QGround Control when I am in the field. So that's why I chose this type of connections. So finally, we have this system. This system is only a Raspberry Pi 02 with a camera connected to it, and this device is connected to internet via this device. Once we have this connection, we can control this drone from any place, and we can stream video from any place, regardless of the location of the drone. Thank you.